Hello, welcome to this webinar. My name is Emily Hermans. I work for Ghent University and for Open Air. And today I will be presenting this introductory webinar on open access to research data and data management for Horizon 2020 projects. So the European Commission started with an open research data pilot in 2014 with the start of Horizon 2020. This was first a limited pilot and is now the default option. The European Commission wanted to foster open science to make science more available for everybody and also try to avoid duplication of research and loss of resources with this pilot. This pilot has two main pillars. One is research data management. For this pillar, the data management planning is an important factor. And the other pillar of the pilot was to try to broaden the access to research data. So there is also a component of open access to research data. So let's first look at the first pillar, data management planning. What is data management? Well, data management is actually part of good research. It gives context to the data that you collect. It explains it. It describes your research process so that other people understand your data. And it provides information about data sets. So even people outside of your project will understand what your research is about and how it relates to your data. It's also about storing data. Make sure that you have copies of your data, make sure that you that the right people have access to the data files, both during and after the project. And it's about deciding what data is valuable and what data to keep and what data to delete. The last part of data management is about access to data. So can you make your data open? If you can, you can gain more impact and you can use data repositories to open your data. And the goal of opening data is increasing transparency to your data and making data available to more people. But what is open data? Well, there's a difference between open data and data sharing. Open data is free access to reuse, repurpose, and redistribute your data at no cost to anybody. Sharing data, on the other hand, is restricted access. So you set a certain conditions or limits to the amount of people that can view your data. For example, if you share data with colleagues, that's sharing data and not really open data. The difference is similar to free hugs for all and more exclusive hugs under certain conditions. So why should we be bothered with data management and open data? Well, there are some advantages, both for researchers and for society. First of all, it prevents data loss. A lot of data sets are not accessible anymore. 80% of data is lost after 10 years. So it maximizes the usefulness of your data set and of your research. You can also write a data paper and get credit for it. And it helps research and society in a way that it promotes integrity and transparency and can help citizen science to work with your data. And last but not least, open data has a much longer shelf life and you can get credit for your data. So these are the benefits of data management and open data. So it's no wonder that the EC is promoting open data. Which areas are participating and how do you know what they do? Well, in 2014, it started with a limited pilot. This means that only some areas were part of the Open Research Data Pilot, and you can check Article 29.3 in your grant agreement to know if you're part of the Open Research Data Pilot. There was a guideline to make a data management plan for every data set that you had, and there was a possibility to opt in if you were not part of the pilot or to opt out. Starting from 2017, all Horizon 2020 projects take part in the Open Research Data Pilot. So participating is the default option for all projects. There was a change. You only have to provide one data management plan for every project, but the possibility to opt out stayed in place. So what are some conditions for opting out? Well, you need to give a reason, but it's a flexible pilot. So there are a lot of reasons that apply. Exploitation of results, or protecting personal data, or if your project does not generate data at all, you can choose to opt out. You can opt out at any stage in your project. So even if you are not sure what kind of data you will produce or if you will be able to take part, you can opt out at a later stage. So you can completely opt out through a project amendment or completely or partly opt out. And then you can describe the issues that you have in your project data management plan. Remember that it's not necessary to make all data sets open. You can, again, describe these issues in your project data management plan. So the mantra of the EC is try to make your data as open as possible, but if necessary, you can keep certain data sets closed. You can find all this information in the FAIR data management guidelines. They give you information on how to comply with the Open Research Data Pilot. It notes the extension of the pilots, it clarifies some concepts, what FAIR data is, it explains what the DMP is and when it should be updated, it knows what happened at proposal submission and evaluation states, and it explains that costs are eligible. So costs for data management or data storing, for example, are eligible in Horizon 2020. It also provides a template for a data management plan. This is not obligatory to use this template, but it is highly recommended. So you can check the guidelines online. What are the requirements of this data pilot? What should you do? Well, first of all, you should write a data management plan. And after the project, you should deposit the data that you want to store in a data repository together with all the necessary information to validate your results. This can be information about the data sets, information about your projects, can, for example, be metadata, everything that is needed to understand the data and your research. And then if possible, through this data repository, you can open up your data. The timeline that you can follow with your data management plan is as follows. At proposal stage, you do not have to write a data management plan yet. You just have to give a basic idea about what data you're going to collect, in what formats it will be, and if you will be able, or you think you will be able, to provide access to it. So it's not a data management plan, but it's a good idea to think at this stage about your budget. Will you need budget for storing your data, for example? You can plan it in proposal stage as well. At 6 months is the first deadline for a first version of your DMP. And then it should be updated. It should be updated if there's any changes in data or in the policy or if there are changes in your consortium. And at periodic evaluation, you should also make sure that your data management plan is up to date. And at the final review, you will need to deliver a final version of your data management plan. So as you can see, a data management plan is not a fixed document. It's a living document that needs updating because at the beginning of the project, you may not know all the information yet about your data set. So it's not a problem if at the beginning you have just a smaller comprehensive data management plan. A data management plan reflects on the curation of your data, how you will preserve it, and how security is handled, and on the sustainability of your data. So how will you be able to, how will your data sets be useful for the future? And then lastly, it also deals with how you can provide access to your data. There are several tools online to help you to write a data management plan. I'm referring here to the tool of the DCC, DMP Online, which also has a template specifically for Horizon 2020 project with the guidelines of the EC and also extra information about the questions and some tips. The Horizon 2020 data management plan, there's ask for specific contexts. You can find the template again in the guidelines. So it has six main topics. You should give information about your data, how it relates with your projects. There are the FAIR data principles. I'll come back to this shortly. Resources, who is going to manage your data management plan and do you need any funding? Data security during your project, who can access your data, how will you manage it, and ethical aspects. So what are these FAIR data principles? Well, they are a set of principles that make sure that your data is findable, accessible, interoperable, and reusable. Findability mainly deals with questions about how can people discover your data, and if they can discover their data, how will people understand your data? So it will ask about metadata, metadata standards, a persistent identifier that identifies your data set, naming conventions, keywords, and versioning. Accessibility deals with questions like where can people find your data and can people access your data? So it deals with software, is there specific software needed to open your data sets, documentation, and also the data repository that you will choose to store your data. Interoperability deals with question how other people may interact with your data and combine your data with their data. So it deals with standard vocabulary and methodology. Reusability mainly deals with question about what can people do with your data and what are they allowed to do with your data? So it mainly deals with licensing. So FAIR data principles are a big topic in the Horizon 2020 data management plans. So this was a short introduction to Horizon 2020 data pilot. And OpenAIR supports this pilot with information. We are a social and technical platform that enables open science and helps people to understand and practice open science. We have a lot of training and support material specifically for the Open Data Pilots. We have information on the Open Research Data Pilots on how to create a data management plan and how to select a good data repository where you can also make your data openly available. And we also have information about personal data and how to anonymize it, and even an anonymization tool. We have a lot of other support material, briefing papers, fact sheets, webinars like this one. We also do workshops. And if you still have questions, there's a help desk available. I hope this webinar was informative for you, and I thank you for your attention.